I love the colorful clothes you wear and the way the sunlight plays upon her hair. I hear the sound of a gentle wind on the wind that lifts her perfume through the air.
I'm picking up good vibrations. She's giving me the excitations. I'm picking up good vibrations.
Hello everyone, today I just wanted to do a very quick video to showcase my Vietnam War collection. This would be used for Broken Arrow events, pickup games, and anything else I find useful.
It's a very sunny day out today, so I'm going to do my best to show you as many dates as I can, and all the details that I can in this video. So to start out, everything was laying on a shelter half, actually two shelter halves to form a complete pup tent. You'll see in this clip here that they're slightly different tones of green. Each man who carried half of a pup tent would also carry five of the orange pegs for the ground, as well as three wooden tent poles that would be connected.
So I have two main uniforms for the Vietnam events. The first one would be a third pattern ripstop uniform. As you can see, we have a top dated 1968, as well as a pair of matching bottoms, also dated 1968. I decided to make myself a set of dog tags, and I will be putting on that airborne patch. That's just for authenticity. I make no claims to be connected to anything in the US military at the moment. Right next to it, we have kind of a mishmash, but this is my backup uniform. We have a 1968 OG-107 sateen utility uniform, as well as a pair of dyed Rothko bottoms. These bottoms are last resort, just in case everything else fails. Up in the top corner, you'll see just a standard OD green cotton undershirt that I'll be using when I'm actually wearing an undershirt. But if we take a trip down, we get to the jungle boots. Now these jungle boots are exactly my size. I got them for a very good price because they are so used and so salty, like most of the other uniform parts. Dated 1968, as far as I can tell, the dating is very worn out. However, we do have the Panama soles, and I believe, as far as I can tell, they're made by Welco. Now this is the crown jewel of any Vietnam loadout. What we have here is an M1 pot helmet. This one was made in about 1970 in Canada for the US military. I also have a 1968 Ingersoll one. However, that one's a little too dented up for my liking. However, the liner is actually dated 1971 with the headband dated just under that. So probably very late 60s. So what I have on here is a 1968 contract Mitchell camo pattern helmet cover, as well as a 1980s helmet band, but I cut the cat eyes off of it, so it's very similar to the 1960s and 70s one. I will actually be replacing this as soon as possible, just when I find one that's a decent price. Now the second half is gonna contain most of my sustainment gear. I put it on a 1968 shelter half, which I mentioned briefly in the beginning of this video. But to start out, what we're looking at is an M1945 sleeping bag cover. This thing is in pristine condition. I got it for $5. I had to pick it up. It's dated 1976, but for what I'll be using it for, kind of as just a mat on the ground to sleep on a little bit more comfortably, it'll work just fine. It'll be inside the pup tent, even though it's a little bit farby. Now this is the main web gear for my kit. What we have is pretty much 1956 everything, a couple first patterns, couple second patterns, but as you can note, this is a very, very basic rifleman setup. So we have two second pattern universal ammo pouches, as well as two M1956 canteen covers. So inside one of those is a Vietnam era canteen, as well as canteen cup, and the other one is an 80s canteen that will be replaced soon. But I can say drinking water out of the 80s canteen is a lot nicer than drinking it out of the gross 60s one. And additionally, in the middle of all that jazz, we have the M1961 butt pack. The only main difference between this one and the 1956 style is the inside has a rubber liner just to help keep things dry. Now our suspenders are actually the M1956 second pattern suspenders with a second pattern compass pouch. There's nothing in there at the moment, but rest assured there will be soon. Now finally, to finish up, I just wanted to cover some of the small miscellaneous things I'll have. But we have a 1968 dated rifle bore cleaner. That thing, I picked it up for $1. It was pretty cool. So that's just kind of, I keep it along with me. But we've also got a 1956 shovel cover. This would normally mount onto the 1961 butt pack, but it would also contain the 1943 shovel I have, but I'm not using that currently as that's on my World War II kit. So I most likely will be looking to pick up a second one, but we'll see as time goes on. We've also got a bandolier. So this is the M3 rifle bandolier. It's meant to house M16 magazines. It actually doesn't have any M16 mags in it, despite what it looks like. That's just cardboard inserts I use for the time being. I wanted to keep all the M16 related stuff for a separate video that you guys will see soon. The only thing that I dislike about this is it's dated 1975. I got it for dirt cheap, so I can't really complain, but hopefully in the future I'll be able to find an earlier one for a decent price. And finally, this is not necessarily for the US Army. This is actually a British M1 howitzer shell that was dated in World War II and then also redated in an ammo lot in 1969. So I just have that with me. It houses all of my tent poles and hooks and everything. But yeah, it's just a cool thing to add on that is technically Vietnam era. But overall, that summarizes everything I've got right now for the Vietnam kit, with the exception of the M16, A1, and magazines. So stay tuned for that video. If you enjoyed this, give it a like, subscribe, and let me know what you thought.